Hi everyone, welcome back. So this is the finale for May the Panning Be With You. It is May 4th when you're watching this, hopefully, if I got this edited in time. I didn't do amazing, but it is my first project pan and I did actually get through a few products. Hopefully this is good enough for a first go. I also had a lot of freaking products in this and I went several weeks without wearing like any makeup, which I really should not have done. Otherwise I would have been done probably half of the products that aren't currently done, but let's just get started. I'll start off with probably the one that I used the least, and it's the Essence Love Letters Highlighting Powder. As you guys know, this is just kind of a powdery powder. It doesn't actually do any highlighting. It's just like a powder that's lighter than my skin with some glitters in it. So this is just gonna go straight to my empties bin because there's nothing that this benefits me with. So that is gone. Another product that I didn't quite finish up but is pretty much done is this Mirabella primer. I wish I could see exactly where it was. My gosh, I'm so close. There's literally like this much, like right up here left in this entire bottle. So I'll probably be done in a week or two at most. But I have been using this every day. I don't know why. It's not done yet. I haven't really been loving it recently. In the last few weeks, I moved to Toronto and my skin has had so much texture that I never had before. Like around this area, the foundation looks really dry and gross. It might be the foundation itself, it might be the applicator. It just hasn't been looking nearly as nice as my foundation usually does. So I'm gonna finish this up and then when it's empty, throw it out. So I don't think I'd buy this. I still have not found my Smashbox. I went through my entire makeup collection, packed that away, and still did not find that Smashbox primer, and I'm really sad about it. Chantel just posted her Mommy Glam, I think that's what she named it, Mommy Glam makeup tutorial, which is like amazing, so go watch that, I'll link it below, where she uses that primer, and I was so jealous watching it. I was like, no, I need that primer back in my life. So Real Techniques sponge, it's okay, but I think it's getting bad now. It's really freaking hard to wash out and I'm so excited to use my beauty blender again, but that won't be for another month because I didn't pack it with me in my temporary makeup collection, which I am going to try and film not next, but I'm going to try and film later this week possibly if it's not raining. So yeah, this has not been as smooth. I feel like this might be like part of the reason why I'm having a bit of texture. Like I'll even zoom in and show you if you can. Yeah, you can see it's like, it looks cakey, and that primer hasn't really been helping fill in my pores recently. I've also been breaking out, and that's probably due to, like, look how bad that looks. That's probably due to me not having my full out skincare routine with me. So, just goes to show how important skincare is. I'm gonna keep using this until we move, and then this is going in the bin. And I will be back to my actual beauty blender that I love so much. This I also did not actually finish using up. I thought this was gonna be completely done. The first one is completely done. I had two of these in Project Pan. I'm just gonna put this on now because I actually didn't wear any today. Oh my gosh. This has like a surprising amount of product in it. It's not my favorite. Like I said, it doesn't actually hold my brows in place. It's like light coverage, I guess, but it's nice for the front of my brows just to give them a little bit more color than they have because I don't like to actually go over pomade heavily in that area. Would I repurchase? No, my opinion has not changed. Go get the Essence one. It's very cheap and better. So this I will keep using until it's actually out. Because my Essence is also packed. I packed everything, it's so bad. But I'm proud. I brought a very condensed makeup collection with me to my mom's. So one product that I am proud of, that I didn't think I would even hit pan on, this Pixi foundation thing, the Flawless Vitamin Veil Foundation number 3 tanned. I actually hit pan right down there. You can see the bottom of the little tin thing. There's quite a lot in here. Well, not actually for foundation, there's not that much in here. But this is gonna go to my empties because I don't like it. It's still too orange on me. I tried, but I hit pan, so I at least got some good use out of it. At least I know I'm never gonna buy it. Something that I completely finished, which I'm very shocked about, this was one of the last things I thought I would finish, is the Do the Hoola by Benefit. This is really orange, but I was using it a lot as like an eyeshadow base, where I would just put it all over my lid and set it with translucent powder so that it could still see some of the color there. That way I wouldn't look like I'm completely dead, and it's just quicker that way than having to full out do an eyeshadow look from when I'm going to work. This is done. I'm scared now that it's gonna squirt something out. Let me... Oh, of course it did that. Where did that even go? But you get the point. It's done. Like, nothing is actually coming out of it anymore. So I'm proud about that. Would not buy. I'm sorry about the lighting. I didn't bring any of my professional lights with me, and it's been very cloudy in May. It's actually gonna snow on the weekend, which is really annoying. It should not be snowing in May. So another product that I completely failed on finishing is the Benefit What's Up, this thing. It looks like I haven't even used any of it at all, but this is actually really pretty. Like, using it every day, I was starting to like it. So I'll keep using it every day as much as I can. I'm not necessarily angry at not finishing that. It was more because it's expired, but it's not doing anything weird. It's not irritating me, and it's pretty, so I don't mind not having that done. And I'm not gonna throw it out if I like it. This lip gloss never seems to end. It was enormous, but it doesn't do anything. It's... You can see, like, a lot of it is gone, but I can't get to that very bottom part at all. And when I pull it out, like, this does nothing. And this one will go to the empties as well, because I really don't need another lip gloss. I finished the Marc Jacobs eyeliner that I hate still. I have not changed my opinion on that. This was, like, a twist-up one, and I used, like, 90% of it. And then, like, when it, like, because this thing, like, melted really quickly and it just kept smudging around, not staying in place. But when I was using it the last time that I went to use it, there was only, like, maybe, like, very slightly longer than the black part up here left of the pencil, and it cracked and fell on the floor into dust, and yeah. So I used 90% of it up, and then the rest fell on the ground and died. What I didn't use up, though, is this white pencil eyeliner. I just have not been into the white pencil eyeliner look in the waterline. But this is a good quality one, so I'm okay with that as well. I'll keep using it. I believe it's the only one I have that's white with me and my mom, so that's okay. The foundation, you can see, very close to being done. And this is one of the only foundations I have here. I have my Makeup Forever one, but that one's a little bit too light, so I've just been mixing these two. I'm surprised I'm not done. I honestly thought I would have been done this by now. But if you guys can see in, it's like, you can see that it's like on the sides, it's completely gone. And from looking down, it looks like it's about here. Like, it's almost done. And I still like it, but if this is what's causing my face to look powdery, I don't know. I'm gonna have to figure out my face situation. It's just been not looking nice with makeup on. I might have to give it a break for a few weeks. But I think it's my moisturizer. I don't have my gel moisturizer with me, do I have that with me? If I do, I'm gonna wear it every night now, because holy crap, does that make a difference. In an update video or something, when this is actually done, I'll talk about whether or not it was the foundation making my face look all patchy, or if it was the lack of good moisturizer, or if it was the primer. I will test it out. So yeah, I like that one. I'm just worried about why my face has been weird. And the Temp 2 highlighting pearl thing, I didn't really get to because, like I said, I'm not gonna wear it on my face because it was completely ruining the texture of my makeup. The only way that I could wear this that would make sense would be as like a body highlight. So I'm gonna wear this in the summer when, you know, my collarbones, my décolleté or décolletage or whatever people call that. This area, like these things, collarbones, yeah, that. When it's summer and those are actually exposed, I'll put this on them and try to look cool, but I'm not gonna put that on and throw a sweater on. It doesn't really make sense. Be a bombshell submissive. It looks like not much has happened, but a lot is gone out of it. I was wearing this thing, like, it's a lot of it is gone. I'm throwing this out though because it's not doing well. Quality wise, I think it's way too old and expired, and it just moves around and it makes my other eyeshadow on top of it like do weird things. But I've used like 85% of it and I'm happy about it because I honestly never would have gone through this ever. And it was starting to get kind of weird, like it was turning kind of green. And then the NYX, this eyeshadow thing, I hit pan on this white shade, which hadn't hit pan before. Yeah, you can see right there I had hit pan. This is almost hit pan. I'm happy I got some good use out of this, but I don't like it. And I'm not gonna try and put it into a different project pan or anything, because I don't like it, and I'm honestly really sick of trying to wear that every day. I have a few other eyeshadow palettes with me that I really want to get to. I want to wear eyeshadow that I like. And last but not least, what I am most proud of is the Essence Silky Touch Blush in 10 Adorable. This was, like, the gap had significantly gotten bigger. And then I was using it, and it finally cracked, and now it's not really usable. I've been wearing it every day regardless, like I'm still wearing it today, but it's just made such a mess now that I held on to this to film the video, and now it's going away, and I can use my Milani blush until the end of the month. But I believe that's it. But I hope you guys enjoyed my first project pan. I hope I didn't fail too badly. I mean, I finished a few products up completely, so I'm happy about that. 3 out of 16 products I did really badly on, and the rest I did really well on, so I'm happy about that. So yeah, give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed, subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you guys maybe in a few days, maybe on Saturday I'll have a video up. If not, I will see you guys next Saturday, the week after, with a lip swatch video, which I'm really excited about. So I love you guys, see you soon.